dermis are glands. They are all exocrine glands. When I say exocrine gland, I mean that this type of gland produces a substance. All glands produce a substance, but this particular type of gland produces a substance that enters into a duct, and that duct leads to a surface. In this case, that would be the surface of the skin. Now, there are two types of sweat glands, eccrine glands and apocrine glands. The eccrine sweat glands are your common sweat glands. They are located all over the body and they produce sweat, that salty, watery substance that is used to cool the body. Apocrine sweat glands, on the other hand, are special sweat glands that are located only in the axilla, the anus, and the genitalia, and they produce a different type of sweat. This type of sweat is more of a fatty, odoriferous type of sweat that bears a very important component called a pheromone. A pheromone is a signaling molecule used in mate attraction. The other kind of gland in the skin we've already discussed, and that is the sebaceous gland. Sebaceous glands produce sebum, and they sit along a hair follicle and release that sebum onto the hair follicle, which lubricates the hair follicle. These type of glands, along with the apocrine glands, become active during puberty. On the next page, you will explore disorders of the integumentary system.